When debating about the greatest goaltenders of all time, many hit the obvious. Waugh, Brodeur, Hasek, and Sawchuk. There are many other players up for debate. However, what do they all have in common? They all played in the NHL. Many leave out players who never laced up for an NHL game, leaving out potential cases for greatest of all time. And one player some tend to forget helped establish a foundation for future goaltenders. And his talent wasn't acknowledged until one game that eventually helped shape him into a superstar. Born in 1955, Vladislav Tretiak started playing hockey at a very young age. He had a unique style of play that made him a secret force to be reckoned with. His impressive numbers began in the 68-69 season. Playing for CSKA Moscow, he would post an insane 6-7 goals against average. The following two seasons in Moscow, he'd post a 2-2-4 and a 2-0-3 goals against average. He would continue to play with Moscow, but also play internationally for the Soviet Union. He wasn't well known outside of Russia until one series in 1972 that would make Tretiak a name many would fear. The 1972 Summit Series, a series featuring the Soviet Union and Team Canada. Canada representing the NHL. Although posting not the best of numbers, Tretiak would shock Canadians and many around the world. He put up a strong fight, but before we can talk about the series that changed everything, we have to talk about his style of play that got him there. Tretiak was best known for his butterfly style play in net. However, he did it in an interesting way. Unlike modern butterfly goaltenders, Tretiak played a style where he combined new aspects of getting low to the ice while including the classic stand-up method. This style of play would form Tretiak's name to fame and help him excel in shocking the hockey world. Now, back to the Summit Series. Everyone thought Team Canada would dominate, but one person was poised to make Canada earn it. Tretiak, although posting an 887 save percentage throughout the series, stoned Canada cold. He robbed numerous players of outstanding plays and stood his ground. He would take the series to the full 8 games. However, the Soviets would lose the series, but he made Team Canada earn a win they all believed would be a shutout. Tretiak wasn't done with his sensational international play. The 1974 Summit Series brought an even better Tretiak. His goals against average improved, posting a 3.57, and he wanted revenge. He played in 7 out of the 8 games in the series, and this time would come on top, helping the Soviets win the Summit Series, making the hype around him expand even more. His international play only improved, and now his team would embark on a series that would find them facing every team in the NHL. Tretiak came to play. He shut out the Montreal Canadiens and ended up with a 3 goals against average during the series. He dominated every team. Except 1976, Flyers vs. the Red Army, a game that would deem one team a nickname that would last a lifetime. They were called the Broad Street Bullies. This will forever go down as one of the most deadliest games in NHL history, worthy of its own video. Some argued the Flyers only won by their tremendous amount of dirty hits, but in the end, they ended up being the only team to take down the Russians in the Super Series. However, this wouldn't impact Tretiak's career. Tretiak's skill in net continued to get even better, and his career went on both internationally and locally. Tretiak would take home many accolades, including 3 Olympic gold medals, 10 World Championship gold medals, and 1 Canada Cup in 1981. In addition, he won 1 silver and 1 bronze World Championship medal, and only got an Olympic silver once, but in the most dramatic fashion. USA vs. USSR, the 1980 Olympics. During a time where both teams were battling political issues with one another, this game was more than just a hockey rivalry. Both teams disliked each other. However, the US team was considered to be a team no one expected to take out the Soviets, let alone stand the chance at winning the gold. Tretiak was in net for about half the game. A questionable call by the coaching staff had Tretiak pulled and replaced with the backup. It was then that the US would score and eventually break the tie. Time was winding down, and both teams realized they were seconds away from cementing themselves in hockey history.
Up yourself! 5 seconds left in the game! Do you believe in miracles? Yes! Unbelievable!
This would take a toll on the USSR, but for Tretiak, it was a learning experience, and he continued to perform. But towards the end of his career, he'd make every save count. Tretiak's final seasons in Moscow would be his best statistically, as he'd post a 170, a 189, and his best goals against average in his career, a 146. However, Tretiak wanted to go big. He wanted to try to play in the NHL. He was drafted by the Montreal Canadiens 138th overall in 1983. However, he would never actually play an NHL game. Many have speculated that that was due to the political tensions with the Soviets at the time, while others speculated it was because during that span of time, Montreal also drafted Patrick Waugh. Many have wondered how well Tretiak would have done in the NHL, and some have even stated he'd be one of the best of all time. He did coach in Chicago for a few years as Ed Belford's goalie coach. Belford has came out and said numerous times that Tretiak helped improve his game. It's a shame we never got to witness Tretiak in an NHL game, because if we did, maybe he'd shock us, just like he shocked the entire world during that one series in 1972.